So hello everyone, my name is Rose Colon and I am a former virtual school student. Being a virtual school student means that you need to work by yourself because the teachers are not physically with you. You cannot raise your hand and wave in the air to ask what sign, cosine, and tangent. In order to be successful in virtual school, you need to have dreams and goals to motivate you, because if you want to give in, it will be really easy. So a lot of students had come to me asking how I do it. People had said to me that they only took one virtual class and they are drowning with their normal classes and their virtual one. Many had asked me how I managed to get straight A's on virtual school and also on normal school. I at first thought that it was just me, like a talent they're born with. But it is actually not. When I started to study my critical thinking class, I discovered that I used many techniques to study and to be a good student without even actually knowing I was using them. So I want to share some key points and tools and techniques to help everyone in virtual or presential school. Growth mindset. This is a very powerful tool and my favorite because it shows how amazing the human brain is, and I had seen the results of a growth mindset myself. Since I don't like history, I took my war history class in the first semester and I only think, oh lord, this is not my strong point, I can never learn this, I will fail this. That made my grades crumble and I was afraid that I wasn't smart enough. On the next semester, the topic was war work, and I love war work, and don't get me wrong, I love how poignant was that moment in the human history. That topic is a sad but interesting thing to learn, and I gave a chance to history saying that I liked the topic, I liked the homework I was assigned to do. I was engaged with the material and I knew then that if I had a positive approach to the module, I was going to ace the class. So that is the first advice. Never limit yourself. You're a smart person and every smart person has their strong points and their weak points. But with a positive insight, even the weaknesses can be overcome. Take organized notes. I have notebooks per class. I take notes for every class. And I changed my note-taking method several times. I used to do corner notes, but that didn't work out, so I kept changing until I found my own method. There is a lot of ways of taking notes, and my advice is to find what helps you best. In my case, I like listing the idea per topic, and in math, work every single example problem until I am comfortable with it. Last but not least, grade. Life is hard. Life can be good or bad. It's your choice, even in times that you certainly think that you cannot choose. There's always a choice, bow and break, or fire guns and blow away your challenges. Do not take that advice literally, please. What I mean is that you can give up and be miserable, or you can stand and face every challenge. I have learned that fighting for what you believe for is the key. As one of my favorite quotes says, the final fight, I'll win. There is hope everywhere, and the sky is the limit. So never believe that you're not enough, because you can always be more. The grit is inside of everyone, and the trick is how to use it and how to learn to use it and never give up. The final fight I win.